Hello everybody, welcome back to the Game Bazaar for another Battlefront 2 video. In this video, I'll be rating each of the reinforcements based on my own personal opinion. This video is quite hard to make due to the fact that all the reinforcements in this game are so unique and powerful. And as always, do not feel bad if I rank your favorite reinforcement poorly, as I respect all of your opinions. Make sure to tell me your opinions in the comments below. Last of all, before I get into the content of this video, I would just like to say that my first place opinion will be completely unexpected. Anyway, let's get into this. Taking its place at the number 15 spot is the Droidica. The Droidica has unmatchable speed and easily has the most effective shield in the game. The Droidica also has insane firepower at short range and can exponentially increase its damage with its overload ability. So why the low ranking, you may ask? If you play as the Droidica a lot, you may have realized just how slow the transformation between the normal form and the wheel form can be. This transformation leaves you indescribably vulnerable and pretty much guarantees death if any adversaries are nearby. Combine this slow transformation time with its horrendous movement speed outside the wheel form, an extremely high damage fall off on this blaster, and the lack of a damaging ability, and you've got yourself a recipe for disaster. At the 14th position is the B2 Super Battle Droid. This droid has pretty great firepower and survivability due to its overload and fortify abilities, and its wrist rocket cannot be noticed as well as a grenade can. The battle droid is best played aggressively, as its blaster is significantly stronger than that of a normal trooper. However, this droid has slow movement speed and pretty worthless dodges, and everything that this droid can do can be better executed by its aerial counterpart. Overall, this droid is like a vamped up version of the assault class, but nothing else. This reinforcement is definitely fun, and its blaster is amazing, but it is definitely outclassed in many ways. Through all the nerfs and changes, I just had to put the ARC Trooper in the number 13 spot. All of the changes do not bug me too much. I know that the changes to this reinforcement are one of the most controversial changes that DICE have created. Some may say that they wanted to balance the ARC Trooper with a new ISB agent, but variety is what makes games last long, and now that they have the same playstyle with their blasters? Anyway, enough ranting on about DICE's faults. The ARC Trooper still deals a substantial amount of damage at close range, and they can definitely still shred heroes by knocking them off their feet with the Shock Trap ability. Combine that with the new Toggle Weapon ability, which allows them to fire faster at the expense of accuracy, and you will be doing insane amounts of damage. They also have decent mid to long range capability with their alternate fire and their regular blasters, which are now much more accurate. With all this in consideration, plus their Wallhack Helmet Scanner ability, you'd think they'd be a bit better, but due to the fire rate nerf and other past nerfs, the ARC Trooper falls behind its other contestants. Honestly, I never thought I would be ranking this reinforcement above the ARC Trooper, but the Flame Trooper beats them out at the number 12 ranking. The Flame Trooper is insane at close range, melting infantry and breaking through lightsaber blocks at ease. Their unique weapon is extremely fun to play as, and using their overload and fortify abilities, they can easily slay unwary heroes. The Flame Trooper can also cause a burn effect to enemies after the Flame Trooper stops targeting them, but this effect is very minor and should not be relied on. Last of all, their Incendiary Imploder is quite nice in taking down enemies and holding down a choke point. Nonetheless, they do have some very distinct disadvantages to top off their powerful close quarters capability. The Flame Trooper has no range other than their grenade, and that has a pretty long recharge time. With just this disadvantage, the Flame Trooper is easily taken down to the spot on the list. A very fun reinforcement nevertheless. Falling right at number 11 is the KFX Spy. The KFX Spy is a very fun and it is kind of the light side's version of the BX Commando droid. It's a GLIE-44, a very accurate and powerful blaster that can destroy troopers with a couple headshots. Or even less if the KFX Spy uses its rapid fire ability. Rapid fire ability is one of the best reinforcement abilities against blaster heroes, as it can shred them in just a few headshots. Not only does a KFX Spy provide high damage, but it can also scan enemies and unleash a stupidly powerful orbital strike with scanner beacon ability. And akin to Jin Erso from Battlefront 2015, the Spy can utilize a truncheon to do powerful melee attacks. However, the Spy's abilities are average, and the truncheon strikes are not even comparable to the vibro sword used by the commando droid. Also, the rapid fire ability is too short to be used against a group of enemies, making it best utilized against a key target. Last of all, the scanner beacon is pretty worthless unless outside, so you can summon an orbital strike, and even then, the strike takes a very long time to execute. Overall, the KFX Spy is an average reinforcement that isn't all that glorious. Placing itself right at the top 10 is the Wookiee Warrior. The Wookiee Warrior has always been a powerful reinforcement, and as it is an enforcer, the Wookiee Warrior can use its overload and fortify abilities to quickly shred troopers and heroes. Its insanely powerful thermal imploder can easily clear out rooms as well, and is also great at dropping behind you to take out your pursuers as you rush to cover. The Wookiee Warrior is almost unbeatable at close range, especially when aiming down sights, but like the old version of Chewbacca, sucks at far range. Not only does it have bad far range capability, the Wookiee Warrior cannot be played as aggressively as other enforcers due to its slow rate of fire. The Wookiee Warrior is undeniably powerful, but has been falling behind as more capable reinforcements have been added to the game. The EA has added some additions to the game that have definitely split up the community, such as the BB droids, the change to the ARC trooper, and this little furball of the reinforcement. Yes, I'm looking no further than the Ewok Hunter to place into the number 9 spot. The Ewok Hunter is very unique, which has caused some complaints that this infiltrator is too weak. I do admit I'm pretty horrendous at using this unit, but just because it requires a lot of skill doesn't mean that it's bad. The Ewok Hunter is by far the most capable sniper in the game, besides the point that its shots are extremely hard to pull off due to the fact that it can do 399 damage in one headshot. That instantly kills all troopers, reinforcements, and brings a hero down to half its health. This little fuzzball honestly should have been the one to take down the stormtroopers and revenge the Sith, not its incapable kin. Anyway, that's off topic. When hip-firing, the Ewok Hunter pretty much has an aimbot, allowing for an easy time in medium range encounters. It also can use its spear for close range encounters, but I advise against it due to its weak damage output. It can also clear out groups with its movement speed deducting Wisties pouch, track down targets with the Hunter's instincts, and sustain survival using the Valiant Horn ability. But best of all, the Ewok Hunter can crouch to half the recharge cost of its abilities, allowing the Ewok Hunter to gain its abilities that much faster. However, due to its weak primary weapon, its hard to learn playstyle, its low health, and its extremely slow movement speed, it is inevitable that this creature had to be placed below its beefier counterparts. At the number 8 position is none other than the Clone Commando. The Clone Commando is an absolute beast at close range, as its DC-17M repeating blaster rifle has an insane rate of fire and a high DPS. Pair this blaster with the Commando's battle focus ability in tough situations to mount enemies while gaining extra health and standing your ground at the game damage reduction. Not only can he do heavy damage and tank tons of shots, but the Commando can also knock enemies off their feet with his repulsor blast to leave them extremely vulnerable to his powerful weapon. Although he has a few downsides as well, his blaster is confusing to newer players due to his backwards heating meter, and its ranged damage is laughable. Thank heavens for the anti-armor attachment, his final ability that allows him to fire a few grenades, doing heavy damage to vehicles and allowing for long range due to its straightforward projectile. However, he can only fire three, and they are extremely slow, so this Clone Commando is still best used at close range or within a group of enemies with his grenades. At the lucky number 7 spot is the First Order Jet Trooper. This aerial has very versatile flying capabilities with its awesome jetpack, and can hover in the air for more accurate firing. Not only does this trooper have a very powerful G125 projectile launcher that can fire blaster bolts, but it can also fire as many grenades as you want, and very quickly as opposed to the Clone Commando. The Jet Trooper can also get out of battle even when their fuel is out using the Jet Tackle ability. This blasts the trooper forward, doing damage to anyone hit and allowing for a hasty escape. However, the First Order Jet Trooper has much more predictable movements than the standard aerial troopers, as one is much quicker and more controllable in direction. I'm also way more used to those troopers, and their rocket launcher is a very reliable one-shot, so overall I just couldn't rate this trooper higher than its aerial counterparts. Just out of the top 5 is Ovissian Gunner. If I had made this video right after the Rise of Skywalker update, I would have immediately rated this unit in 1st or 2nd place, but I've come to realize that this unit is not my favorite due to nerfs and changes in my playstyle. The Ovissian Gunner can take down infantry and heroes in seconds with their primary weapon, or take down groups of enemies at a choke point in vehicles with her anti-armor mode. However, her best feature is that she can heal herself and nearby allies for tons of health using her defensive stance ability. This ability does slow down movement speed, but also allows for a sustained fire throughout the duration of the ability due to the absence of overheating. However, even with one of the highest DPS stats in the game, the Gunner has quite a few downsides. First off, she is as slow as heck. At least she isn't as slow as the Ewok, though. She also has to charge up her weapon quite a bit before she fires, and she simply doesn't have the means to escape a battle quickly unless she uses her charge ability, which does have a decent recharge time, however. Overall, the Gunner can take tons of damage, but her lack of swiftness limits her overall potential. The number 5 spot is the new incarnation of the Death Trooper. This variant of the Death Trooper has an incredibly balanced weapon that is capable of all sorts of encounters, as opposed to their former weapon that was only effective at short-range encounters. Although the Death Trooper cannot do the sheer damage it used to be able to with the overload plus fortify combo, this trooper can now stay on the move during these abilities to ensure survival. The grenade is one of the best in the game, as it blinds and slows enemies, but it is currently bugged so that its wall hack ability does not work. The Death Trooper is just overall an incredible reinforcement, and they don't have many downsides, and they are extremely fun to use. Once they get the Sonic Imploder to reveal enemies on the map again, the Death Trooper will be an even greater force that you do not want to mess with. Pushing in the top 5 at number 4 is the new ISB Agent class. This may be an interesting choice, but hear me out. Her pistols are pretty good for medium range damage and her secondary fire is great, but her abilities are where her true usefulness lies. Her abilities are very similar to the Sith Trooper, which makes her powerful enough already. Her Imperial Intel ability is a carbon copy of the Sith Trooper's Seeker Tactics ability, and her Double Your Effort ability pretty much heals all your health back very quickly if it affects an ally as well. However, her most insane power lies in her melee attacks. Not only does her close combat passive ability restore 100 health when killing enemies with her melee, she also has a very quick and evasive melee that really shines to improve her playstyle. Combine that with her third and final ability, Assault Training, which increases speed and grants damage reduction, and you will be unstoppable in taking down targets and melees while surviving. Her melees can easily beat out an AI hero or any trooper. For some awesome clips of ISP agent melees, check the link to Harrison James's video below. All I can say is that video is as dank as heck. However, if you don't utilize her abilities in perfect tandem with her melee attacks and her pistols, the ISP agent will be one of the weakest reinforcements. The ISP agent may take a bit more practice than the ARC trooper, but the practice will definitely pay off. My man, the Sith trooper, makes it at the number 3 pick. The Sith trooper is cool enough cosmetically, but his abilities work so well in tandem with each other, it's not even funny. His blaster is so lit and its DPS is so high. That alternate fire coral blast is also extremely powerful and can also almost one-shot infantry that aren't the heavy class. Not only does the Sith trooper have one of the best blasters in the game, but he also boasts a useful seeker tactics ability I mentioned when I was talking about the ISB agent that will allow you to hunt down enemies very speedily. He also has an amazing combat rush ability that makes him so he pretty much can't die, as it gives him insane health regeneration after every kill. Last of all, he boasts the best grenade in the game, the fast-ticking oppression grenade that prevents health gain and leaves enemies at critical health to be slayed by your STW-4A blaster rifle. The Sith trooper doesn't really have any weaknesses, but its attacks are slightly weaker than some of the reinforcements, putting it here instead of a higher place on the list. The runner-up for today's video is the Commando Droid. The Commando Droid has great speed and agility with both its normal sprinting and its dodges, and even better if you chain its fiber sword and its dodges into a sort of speed combo. The Commando Droid's E5 blaster has a very effective range, and it fits in perfectly with their playstyle. Not only do they have a great mid-range damage, but they have their amazing vibro sword melee that can easily take down even heroes at point-blank range. Last of all, the BX Commando Droid has both a smokescreen and thermal vision abilities that allow them to sneakily kill enemies. Like the Sith Trooper, the Commando Droid doesn't have many weaknesses, but I think I'm quite better with the Commando Droid, so that's why I ranked as Infiltrator at the second place spot. Before I reveal my favorite reinforcement in Star Wars Battlefront 2, remember to like, subscribe, and ring the notification bell for more Battlefront and other gaming videos. Also, feel free to recommend what video I should do next, as your support is definitely welcome. Now, back to the video. If you remember what I said at the beginning of the video, I bet that not a single one of you would have guessed this. But today, I'm ranking the number one pick as the traditional aerial class. Most people consider this class weak and definitely weaker than the First Order Jet Trooper if anything, but this class has always been my favorite part about Battlefront 2 since I started playing it. This class has tons of mobility, and their movements with their jetpack are much more unpredictable than Boba Fett's and the First Order Jet Troopers. Not only are they less predictable, but they also have a very quick cooldown with the right star cards, and they can rack up tons of damage on open maps while in the air. With the combination of their mid-range blasters, their one-shot rocket launcher that can shred even heroes, and their unpredictable mobility, the aerial class is easily my favorite reinforcement in Battlefront 2. Yes, they have low health and they kinda suck in enclosed maps, but the aerial is a force if played correctly. Thank you all for watching this video. Please remember to like and subscribe on the way out, and be sure to comment below what your opinion on your favorite reinforcements are. I will be making more Battlefront 2 videos very soon, and I definitely would love suggestions from you guys. And until next time, remember, the Force will always guide you.